So this is a sample of osmium. Osmium, again, is a precious metal, platinum group metal. And this is an osmium sponge, which is very nicely packaged up in this box. But let's have a look and see if we can find it.
So osmium is another one of the elements in the so-called platinum group. And it is quite unusual in that its oxide, osmium tetroxide, is a stable compound, but it's really quite easily evaporated. It has quite a strong smell, which is unusual for metal compounds, and it can be evaporated quite easily. And it is used in organic chemistry because if you have compounds with double bonds between two carbon atoms, osmium tetroxide reacts with it quite easily.
So here the osmium itself, okay, it's a very, very reactive metal. It's sealed in this glass ampoule under an inert atmosphere of argon so that it can't oxidize. The argon is very inert and it stops the metal reacting. So here you can see this very, very dark black metal, very fine, spongy type material at the bottom of this glass vial.
Again, osmium has played some role in my life because I have did some of the early work in my doctorate involved osmium compound. It was ruthenium and osmium and iron. The ruthenium compound was orange. The osmium compound, a rather fetching pale green, pale yellow, and the iron compound, a very dark green. And the osmium compound was perhaps the most boring because it behaved in exactly the way that was predicted.
So osmium reacts with the air to form osmium tetroxide, which is a very, very toxic material. Makes us go blind, so we have to be very careful with storing the osmium.
Since then, I think I made one osmium compound that nobody had ever made before. I wasn't enough to see, but I could see the absorption of light by this compound, so I was really quite excited.
Do you remember what it was in it? Or
what?
Do you remember what it was, the compound?
The compound was osmium dicarbonyl dinitrazyl. And it was interesting because nobody had ever made this compound before, but it was similar to a compound of iron, which was quite well known. The compound of iron looked like blood. It was really quite a dramatic compound. I never found out what the colour of the osmium compound was. I didn't make enough. But I'm not a very good synthetic chemist.